Good morning class, I am Padmini. In our previous class, we have discussed parts of speech. So today's class is based on adverbs, which is also a part of speech and its formation. So question comes, what is an adverb? An adverb is a word which modifies a verb, an adjective or another adverb. So see the examples here. For example, when we say Geeta writes beautifully, Geeta writes beautifully. So writes is the verb and beautifully is the adverb. So here beautifully modifies the verb writes. How Geeta writes? Geeta writes beautifully. The same way, when we say the dog is a very faithful animal, the dog is a very faithful animal. So faithful is what? Faithful is an adjective and very is an adverb. So here the adverb very, it qualifies or modifies the adjective faithfully. So the dog is a very faithful animal. The same way we can say the old man worked very slowly. The old man worked very slowly. Here slowly is what? Slowly is an adverb. So the old man worked very slowly. Very is what? Very is an adverb. So in this sentence, the adverb modifies another adverb in the sentence. So from here, we can get the definition of an adverb. So what is an adverb? An adverb is a word which modifies a verb, an adjective or another adverb. So next we will come to kinds of adverbs. So how many kinds of adverbs are there? So there are 9 kinds of adverbs. There are 9 kinds of adverbs. They are adverb of place, adverb of time, adverb of manner, adverb of degree, adverb of place, adverb of frequency, adverb of relative, or we can say relative adverbs, adverbs of region and adverbs of affirmation and negation, and adverbs of region. Like that, 9 types of adverbs are there. Number 1, adverb of manner. So what is an adverb of manner? An adverb of manner tells us how or in what manner an action has been done. Means question comes here, how? For example, the acrobat jumped carefully. The acrobat jumped carefully. We will make it question. How did the acrobat jump? The acrobat jumped carefully. So always remember, adverb of manner, it tells us how or in what manner or in what way an action has been done. Just another example, the child writes neatly. She writes beautifully. They did the work carefully. So carefully, beautifully, neatly, nicely, these all are examples of adverbs of manner. So always remember, adverbs of manners are those type of adverbs which shows or indicates how an action has been done, and question always asks how. Number 2, adverb of place. Adverbs of place tell us where an action has been done. So question obviously comes here, where. For example, we can say the teacher looked for Meena everywhere. The teacher looked for Meena everywhere. So everywhere suggests or tells about the place. So when we make it question, where did the teacher find Meena? We can say, or where did the teacher look for Meena? So the teacher looked for Meena everywhere. So another example is also, they are going out. So out is also an example of adverb of place. Like Some prepositions also used as the adverbs of place, like you're beside, behind, around, across, along. These also used as the adverbs of place also. Like upstairs, downstairs, inside, outside, there, here. These all are also examples of adverbs of place. So always remember, adverbs of place always indicates where an action has been done, and the question comes where. Number 3, adverbs of time. So adverbs of time indicate the time of action, or it tells us when an action has been done. For example, Rita will come tomorrow. So tomorrow, when will Rita come? Rita will come tomorrow. So question comes here, when. The same way I can say, my friend came late to the party. So my friend came late to the party. So late is also an adverb. And it is what kind of adverb? It is the adverb of time. Like we can say, yesterday, today, tomorrow, recently, afterwards, then nowadays, late, soon, till. These all are examples of adverbs of time. Next, number 4, adverbs of degree. So adverbs of degree indicates or tell us to what extent an action has been done. To what extent an action has been done. For example, the story was very interesting. The story was very interesting. So here, this shows us to what extent the story was interesting. The story was very interesting. Another example I can give. It is so hot today. It is so hot today. So to what extent hot is today? It is so hot today. Or we can say it is very hot today. Or another example also we can give. She is quite fast in calculating maths. She is quite fast in calculating maths. So here this quite, very, so. These are the examples of adverbs of degree. So adverbs of degree always ask, or it always tells to what extent an action has been done. Fairly, almost, extremely, nearly, like, too, hardly. These all are also examples of adverbs of degree. Next, number 5, that is adverb of frequency. Adverb of frequency indicate or tell us how often an action has been done. How often an action has been done. For example, we can say, he rarely visits the museum. He rarely visits the museum. I seldom go to my uncle's house. I seldom go to my uncle's house. This rarely, seldom, this tells us how often we are doing or the action has been done. So when the adverbs which tells or which indicates that how often an action has been done is known as the adverbs of frequency. Like sometimes, every time, usually, these all are also examples of adverbs of frequency. Number 6, relative adverbs. Relative adverbs means when the words when, where, why are used to join sentences are known as the relative adverbs. For example, I cannot find the house where my aunt lived earlier. I cannot find the house where my aunt lived earlier. So these two sentences we have joined with the word, within adverb, and that is known as the relative adverb. So relative adverbs are those adverbs which used to join sentences. Next, number 7, your adverbs of region. Words like hence and therefore are called adverbs of region. One example, he didn't work hard, or he did not work hard, therefore he failed in the examination. So why he failed in the examination? Because he did not work hard. So he did not work hard, hence he failed. So when we talk about any region, then we will use the adverbs of region. Hence and therefore are the examples of adverbs of region. Next, number 8 is interrogative adverbs. So what is interrogative? Interrogative adverbs are those adverbs which ask questions. Question words, or we can say the WH family, like when, where, how many, how much, how often, how long, why. These all are used for asking questions about what? About time, about place, about manner, about quantity, about region. Or we can say about frequency or of an action. So these are known as the interrogative adverbs, and they usually come at the beginning of a sentence. How? For example, where, when did the children go to the party? When did the children go to the party? Where was the building constructed? Like this, we can form the questions, or we can form the question with the use of WH words at the beginning of the sentence. So like who, whom, where, which, what, how much, how long, why. These all are known as the interrogative adverbs. Your next adverb, that is adverb number 9, is adverbs of affirmation and negation. So what is affirmation and what is negation? Affirmation means positive and negation means negative. So we can say adverbs of affirmation and negation express assertion or denial. For example, she will definitely come. She will definitely come. She is not willing to come. So here we can give that she will definitely come. She will definitely come. Here shows it's the assertion. Or we can say affirmation. She is not willing to come. Here it shows it's the denial, or we can say negation. So here the positive and the negative. This is known as the adverbs of affirmation and negation. So already we have discussed the 9 kinds of adverbs. Now we are going to discuss the formation of adverbs. How can we form adverbs? As we know, most of the adverbs of manner, they end with ly. So in an adjective, if we will join ly or ily, then we can form adverbs. For example, light. Light is an adjective. If we will add here ly, then what happened? Lightly. Lightly is an adverb. The same way, kind. Kind is an adjective. But when we used here ly, kindly. Kindly becomes an adverb. Kindly becomes an adverb. The same way, some words they take ily. For example, heavy, H-E-A-V-Y, heavy. So instead of y, we have to use ily, heavily, heavy, heavily. Heavy is an adjective and heavily is an adverb. Some words they end with l, like general. So what we have to use? We have to double the l, means generally. So we have to use generally, means double ly. Like that, beautiful. Last letter is L, or we can say beautiful ends with L. So beautifully become an adverb. So here, when the word ends with L, then we can double the L to form the adverb. So in this way, we can form the adverbs. I think, viewers, you have understood this.